What is the purpose? What is the objective of this accounting standard? Why we basically needs this accounting standards? And the very important purpose is to standardize various policies and practices. We want to standardize. We cannot leave on the corporates to have their own accounting policies, because we want there should be a proper mechanism to have the comparability and the reliability of the financial statements. All of you might be aware that now it is mandatory that when you are presenting your accounting statement, financial statements, you have to give the figure of the previous financial year as well, whether it's a profit and loss account or it's a balance sheet. But when I'm comparing my result of the previous year, I want to know when I'm reading balance sheet, and it's very important, all of you must know how to read balance sheet, that when I'm reading the balance sheet, I am comparing my information, my output, my results with the previous financial year. But the comparability would be meaningful only when the norms were common. It is not when I'm talking about the year 2010, the method of revenue recognition is different, and 2011, the revenue recognition method is different. So comparability. And when I'm talking about the investment in the stock market, when I'm comparing my HDFC bank with the Axis bank, or the Axis bank with the Dhanlakshmi bank, or Dhanlakshmi bank with the UCO bank, within the sector of the banking, the norms of preparation of the financial statement should be common. Otherwise, I may not be able to take a proper financial decision. And when you have the diversified options and choices in financial statement, accounting standards plays a very important role. When you say how these standards are being set, what is the process? Who is going to set this standard? And what is the legal backing or recognition of these accounting standards? In India, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, being the premier accounting body in the country, is formulating accounting standards since 1977. ICAI is having an accounting standard board, where you have the participation of the all interested groups, all regulators, including SEBI, RBI, the government nominees from the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Ministry of Finance from the revenue side, and you have the representation of CII, FICCI, SOCHEM, plus you have the professionals in the board, and it's a very big board, and they are responsible for making accounting standards for various aspects of the business transactions. And till date, 32 accounting standards have been issued by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India on various aspects of financial statements, whether it deals with the government grants, whether it deals with the retirement benefits, whether it deals with the intangible assets, whether it deals with the patent rights, copyrights, or the R&D expenditure in the business. It has the detailed explanation that how all these events and transactions should be carried out in the financial statements.